Good morning, all. Are you ready to start? So in this training session, we will be talking about vocabularies. Is anybody in the room that has not heard about the vocabularies of SeaDataNet at all? No. Okay, that's good. Because I will start a bit assuming that you know. So SeaDataNet is underpinned, is based on vocabularies that are hosted in the British Oceanographic Data Center. They are lists of standardized terms that are related to the oceanographic and wider community. And today we will be talking about mostly about P01, which is the parameter usage vocabulary. If you've ever heard of that, but it doesn't matter because you will learn more today. So P01 is a controlled vocabulary that you can use to annotate or give labels to the data channels and data value fields of your data sets. So you have a data set and you try to say what this data set is measuring. The labels of these measurements will be coming from P01 vocabulary. P01 became a structured compound, I would say complicated is the term for the compound vocabulary in 2004, and it is supported by a number of semantic models. When I say semantic models, I mean the structure behind how P01 is constructed. P01 has underpinned BODC data management systems since the 1990s, and it was adapted by SeaDataCloud and more recently by the Ocean Biogeographic Information Systems to facilitate data exchange, interoperability, and discovery. This is a simple list of some of the terms of P01, and as you can see here, each term has an identifier that is a unique code to refer to this term, but it also has a preferred label or a title and a definition and also a date that was created or last modified. The complicated compound part is the preferred label. So what this means is that each part of this label is constructed by the labels of other vocabularies. So it's not just a simple sentence. Each part of this sentence is a concatenation of the titles of other vocabularies. And this is what we will be explaining today. So a while ago in BODC, we decided to create this conceptual model. So create our titles as a concatenation of titles of other vocabularies in order to standardize these titles, but also not lose or at least lose the minimal information that we could lose. We did that in order to be consistent, in order to give unambiguous names and definitions, and in order to be meaningful to the human user. But that also helps machine-to-machine interaction and makes P01 labels machine understandable. So why would you use a P01 code? When you have a data set and you have measured something, you want to map this something to a P01 parameter code. In order to do that, it's important that you understand the BODC semantic models, the components that they have, and the structure and logic that they are behind them. When you try to map your measurement to a P01 code, it's important to answer these three questions. What is your object of interest? what is your property and what is your matrix. We will show you several tools with which you can search for the P01 terms, and then it's up to you which one you want to choose. When you measure something that is a chemical entity, it's important to use external identifiers such as CAS numbers, but also if you use biological measurements, it's important to map them to identifiers that are on the web, like AFI IDs, ETSTSNs, when it is appropriate. And we have to recognize that mapping your measurement variables to P01 is not an easy job to do. The modeling can be very, very subjective, so errors can happen. So if you want to provide feedback to P01 codes, you can give that to the vocab.services@bodc.ac.uk. So the first semantic model that we will explain is the parameter, the P01 parameter semantic model. And this is how it looks like. So you have a title, and this title has three parts, three elements, a property, an object of interest, and a matrix. Later on, it can be enhanced by a statistical qualifier, a measurement-to-matrix relationship, and some optional fields related to the analytical and processing method. And these are some examples, because I think the examples are easier to understand. So the first one says that my property is concentration, my object of interest is ammonium, I don't have a statistical qualifier, there is a measurement to matrix relationship, which is the per unit mass of the, and then the matrix is the water body, which is dissolved plus reactive particulate. The same example underneath is exactly the same, but it adds the statistical qualifier, which is standard deviation. If I turn the page, I would just explain what the parameter entity is. So the first part, which is the property, is a quantitative or nominative property of an object of interest. So we can say the concentration or the abundance, and you will see several other terms that you can use. The object of interest is a chemical, biological, or physical entity. In this example, it is ammonium. And then the matrix is the environment where you measured that property, the environment entity to which the chemical, biological, or physical entity relates to, and is, or it is embedded. Now, the statistical qualifier, which is the standard deviation, if it's not present at all, it is not specified, then the reported property is the parameter entity, just concentration. If it is used, then we are talking about the statistical parameter of this property. And the different vocabularies behind that, behind the whole model, are shown on the screen. My way of understanding this model, it may be different than other people's, but is going to the vocabulary builder. So we were talking about the P01 semantic model that can have chemical entities, biological entities, and physical entities. If you click on the first one, which is the chemical parameter code builder. It looks like exactly the screen that I was showing you. It has a measurement property. It has a statistical qualifier, a chemical substance, a measurement matrix relationship, and a matrix. And the example that we were seeing on the screen with the concentration, can I maximize that? Yeah. So I can build the example that we were seeing on the screen as concentration. We can put ammonium, and then we can, how can I go up? Yeah, okay. This one, no. So it doesn't show me the scrolling bar.
It's here.
Yeah.
You just use the mouse like this.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Okay. So when I select something, you will see the sentence being built on top of that here. Okay, and you can use this tool to understand the semantic model behind each one of the entities that the P01 parameter model offers. So you can see chemical entity parameter codes, biological entity parameter codes, and physical entity and other parameter codes. I'm going back here. The P01 parameter model includes two more compound vocabularies, and these are the measurement matrix semantic model and the biological entity semantic model. I'll go back. So the matrix semantic model is also a compound vocabulary, and it includes four elements: the sphere subgroup, the face, and the face subgroup. Again, going to the vocabulary builder, if you click on the matrix concepts, you can see that you can select a term like water body on the sphere name, see what you can select from the subgroup name, see what you can have on the face name, like particulate, and create your own terms here so that you can understand how the model works. If the matrix is set to biota, then you can also see that there is another compound vocabulary which is called the biological entity semantic model, and you can find that again here. I won't expand on these ones, but I'll just show you the wheels, the different components that these vocabularies have, as shown in the PowerPoint presentation. So when you will mostly be doing the job of mapping a measurement to a P01 code. So when you do that, the question to ask yourselves is, what is my object of interest? As we saw, it should be a chemical, a biological, or a physical entity. So that's the next question. Is it chemical, biological, or physical entity? Or I'm not sure. Then the next question is, what kind of quantity of or property was measured? Is this the concentration? Is this an abundance? In what environment or on what substrate was the observation made? So is this in the water, in the atmosphere, where it is? How is the measurement reported? What basis was used? What units? How was the measurement made? Was the sample filtered? And then if it was, then check the pore size or filter type. So when you make a measurement, answer all of these questions. And when you have answers to all of these, then go to the P01 and do your mapping. Tools to help you do that are, one of them is the hierarchical search. For inexperienced users that don't know anything about P01, this is a very nice tool supported and hosted by MARIS in order to explore and browse parameter discovery terms. If I think I have it open here. So you have all the links, but so this is a list of several disciplines. Let's say that we select the chemical oceanography. If I click on that, I can then see several other categories under the chemical oceanography. I will select the dissolved gases. I can then see the P02 vocabulary, which is another more detailed list of codes. Then I can select the dissolved oxygen parameters in the water column. And that allows me to see all the P01 codes under that. So we've done a hierarchical search from disciplines. We went to P03 categories, to P02 and then P01, which is the most detailed parameter code. Do you understand me? Is it understood? Okay, hope. Now, you can also use the vocabulary search tool that is hosted by the NVS. By BODC. It's called the NVS search tool, and you can search using wildcard characters like these ones. So I can search for the concentration of chlorophyll A in the water body using spectrophotometry, and in order to do that you would use wildcard characters. I'll show you the tool. its main advantages are that you can search on the identifier, the preferred label, the alternative label, and the definition. You can see the definitions on the screen. You can output a full record of a selected parameter to a file. And you can link a full record to a full record and mappings. And you can also see P02 codes associated with the P01s that you are selecting. So I'll do the example so that you know how to search. So we are searching for the concentration of chlorophyll A in the water body using spectrophotometry. So in order to do that, I'll go to the vocabulary search. I'll select the third option. And I'll say that I want to search in the P01 vocabulary. I can either type it here. I can click search. I'm now in the P01 vocabulary. And I want to search for the concentration. Chlorophyll A. If I just search for that, then I have 175 codes that are a bit too many, so I need to minimize my results. So I'll put the water body, and then I'll use the method as well. So I now have 25 records. Because I can't see them all together, I use the advanced option and I say I want to see the first 50. And this is a list, of codes that all are concerned with the concentration of chlorophyll A per unit volume of the water body. And then you have different phases, you have filtration, you have analytical methods, and it's up to you to see if the code exists or if you want to create a new code. Is this understood? Because I will ask you to do some questions afterwards with these tools. So there is another tool that Maris has developed as well, which is the semantic component faceted search using that tool. And I'll click on that. It is best for users that are not very familiar with the P01 parameter dictionary and its semantic construction. You can start with a keyword, and then you can drill down the list of possible codes selecting terms relevant to the search. So if we search for the same term with Maris tool. No, it's not here. It's not here. So in order to find it, you write CDataNet bandit, which is the one arm bandit. And it's first. So this tool shows you the different components of the vocabularies. My first job would be to write, so I still want to find the concentration of chlorophyll A in the water body using spectrophotometry. So I can write here chlorophyll. A. Now I have only 188 results. This tool minimizes the rest of the results, so you can now select the per unit volume of them. So I can only have 142 results now. And then you try to go to the methods and find the spectrophotometry, if I find. So this is the method. So I can open it up and find spectrophotometry. Here it is. So now I can see 15 codes and I can select which one is the one that I want. Finally, you can do the same with the vocab builder, the NVS vocab builder, which is here. Because it is a chemical entity, so that's the first question you need to ask yourself. I will search again for the chlorophyll A and the concentration and the water body. So I will go to my chemical substance, wanting it to be chlorophyll A. And then, what was that? Concentration. Now I have half of my sentence there, and I see that I still have 118 exact matches. If I open that, I will start seeing what is the result of my, what are my results. I still want to have the per unit volume of the Now I have zero matches, so I did something wrong, probably, since I don't have any more matches, which means that because I put per day, so per unit volume of the. Now I have 96 exact matches, and I want to go to the water body. And now I have zero, so I know that I need to have a filtering method to use. So I'll clear the selection, I'll see what is there, and then I'll try to pick from the help. Okay? Now, many times people submit codes to BODC, and the way that somebody models a code can be very, very subjective. So my colleague wanted us to know how different codes can be very, very subjectively modeled. So a code that was submitted as concentration of tar per unit dry weight of sand by sieving and gravimetry became dry weight, so that's the property, of tar, which was the object of interest, residues per unit area of the sediment by sieving, picking, and gravimetry. If you see this code now, can you understand the property, the object of interest, and the matrix? So these are the three main parts that you need to understand, and then you can add the rest of them in the end. Another code that was submitted for biota entries was the number for Onida larvae, and that became abundance of brachiopoda per unit volume of the water body by optical microscopy. So it's very, very subjective. It can be modeled differently. You have something in your mind, but it can be something very, very different. So that's why Gwen wanted these kind of examples to be conveyed. So I'm gonna, what time is it? Okay, I still have time so that you do your exercises. I will use the faceted search tool of Maris to find chlorophyll A extracted from a water sample filtered on GFF, extracted in acetone and analyzed by fluorometry and expressed in micrograms per liter. So in order to do that, so I'm searching for chlorophyll A. My matrix is, so this is my object of interest, chlorophyll A. My matrix is the water. I also have a filter, which is the GFF. My chlorophyll A was extracted in acetone, and it was analyzed by fluorometry and expressed in micrograms per liter. That normally is the per unit volume of the. So if I go to the Maris tool to do that, I'll reset everything. The first thing I normally do is search for chlorophyll A. So the object of interest. Then the second one was, I know that it is concentration, so I have less terms. I know that the filtering method was GFF, so I can search for GFF here. So the per unit volume of the on the measurement matrix relationship can help me a bit minimize my results. And now my matrix needs to have the GFF. I can't really see it very clearly. Dick, this could be Dick and Pete. Dick? No. So that could be an enhancement so that we can see the bigger screen, so that we can select the GFF. Or I just write GFF here. So now I only have 31. And I also have a method, which was the... I also have the acetone and fluorometry. So filtration acetone extraction is the sample preparation method. I now have 26 terms, and we said that our method is fluorometry. So if you go to the analytical method, you select your fluorometry, and you now have 11 terms. So mine is the concentration. I didn't want standard deviation, so it's not that. So it's the concentration of chlorophyll A per unit volume of the water body by filtration, acetone extraction, and fluorometry. So this is the term that I was looking for. No statistical parameter, just this one. So that's a way to do it. Now I will use the search tool from BODC to find chlorophyll A extracted from a water sample filtered on GFF, extracted in acetone, analyzed by fluorometry, and expressed in micrograms per liter. So what I can do is I can go to the NVS search. I can keep the concentration, I can keep the chlorophyll A, I can keep the water body. I will put the acetone here. Keep your wildcard characters as the percent. And see what happens with this. So this gives me 117 records. I need to minimize it somehow. We want the GFF. So after the water body, we can use the GFF. Now I have 42 records, and I also want the fluorometry. This can be in the end. So now I only have 12 records, and my record was the concentration of chlorophyll A, it's not that, per unit volume of the water body. I just want the GFF. Chlorophyll A per unit volume of the water body by filtration, so this is the one. No, it's not, because it has the 5 UM. So it's this one. And finally, so is this understood? Because you will do an exercise on these ones, on these tools. If you want to show you more, but you can use the wildcard character, see what it returns, and then help yourselves with the results and filter out what you don't want to see. So for the NVS search tool, you use the percent as a wildcard. The P01 labels always start with an uppercase, and the spelling is British English, not American. So keep that in mind when you search for something. And using the vocab builder to find the same thing is checking that you really want the chemical parameter. You want the chemical parameter code. Selecting it and then gradually minimizing your results. So again, it's and then it's concentration, and you can check your results by showing and hiding this bar up here. This tool is mostly useful, apart from learning the models. When you create an account, you can submit codes to the vocabulary management group. So if you log in and you can't find your code, you can submit the code through the tool. So if I log in here, if you don't find the code, then there is a new button that opens up where you can create a code. If you want to create, if you want to play with the tool, just put on the comments that you are testing, because else you give more work to the people that are behind the tool and they will seriously look at them and they will contact you. So please, if you play with the tool, just put "I'm just testing" or "playing", or don't consider it as a serious submission. My other colleague James also uses the ISIS vocabularies. So ISIS also has vocabularies when datasets are submitted, and these vocabularies are again a concatenation of other vocabularies. So, for example, in order to express mercury in pleuronectes platessa in the liver of a female, the wet, so this is the concentration of mercury per unit wet weight of biota in the female liver of this species. In order to be able to map ISIS codes to P01 codes, the vocab builder is a really, really useful tool, and you can do this example later on. My ex-colleague Rob Thomas with Hans in ISIS have done a lot of work mapping codes from ISIS to P01, and you can find the vocab builder, I think, very helpful to do that. I will let you practice a bit so that I don't talk all the time. So I will be coming around to help you out. The first example that we would like you to do to practice the selection of complex matrices is to find, so you can use, I would suggest that for this exercise, you use the MARIS faceted tool, which is, if you Google SeaDataNet Bandit, it's the first one that comes up, and also the MVS search tool. So we want you to find the P01 codes for a data set that contains size fractionated chlorophyll A extracted in acetone and analyzed by fluorometry, reported in micrograms per litre for the following size fractions. So there is one code for the 0.2 to 2 fraction, one code for the 2 to 20, one for the 20 to 200, and one for more than 0.2 microns, obtained by summing the concentrations in the sized fractions. So you need to find four different codes, and if you click in each one of them, you can also find the P02 equivalent. You want to start? I will help you. So that you can do that in two tools. The first one, or select which one you would like. I would suggest to either use NVS search. So in order to find it, you write NVS to search in Google, and it's the first choice. Or this tool, the Maris SeaDataNet Bandit. Whatever you think would be more useful to you. I'll put the exercise again here.